you arrive.
Oh, yes. We have only a brief window of opportunity. The darkness is thick here, coalesced inside this effigy of Emperor Kallus. It is tethered to his very mind. I have snared that thread, caught it between my fingers and woven it into a tapestry. One that I can weave you into. Enter Kallus' consciousness. Use this opportunity to steal his darkness from him.
Now go. Time is of the essence. I will leave you apart.
This is not what I anticipated. The imprint of Kallus' consciousness is fractured, straining, as if Kallus' mind is at war with itself.
All my history is etched here. From humble beginnings, my rise as an emperor is an ancient tradition of our people.
Kallus? No, not Kallus, but an echo of him. This is a recollection of a time since past.
My failure of conquest is so grand, because I lived a grand life. Following me, my daughter, you will be just as majestic.
You are experiencing echoes of Kallus' personal torment. Glimpses into his past which may provide insight to the future. I must focus to maintain your connection to this mindscape. From here, you must navigate these memories on your own.
Ah! Excellent! Is the mighty Gahl too great a coward to kneel down and take my head from my shoulders?
I am as you made me. And I will kill you for it, my choice.
Blade.
No one of honor will be intruded here. The dead are raw materials and nothing more. Thank you. any star I've ever beheld. I name her Caiatl, for the brightest star in our sky. May she outshine it always.
Thank you.
Alice's truth is laid bare. From his rise, to his fall, to whatever it is he is becoming now, Callus is seeking transfiguration. He believes it will help him better understand the goals of the Witness, the final shape. This is something I have heard spoken in Hive Apocrypha, and from the lips of Tolan the Shattered, according to the Hive.